And as you can tell, obviously, healthcare is going to be a big part of my platform for various both professional and personal reasons. Again, Chad's going to hurt, I'm not going to be happy with me now, but our story is Chad does have a twin brother. So, you know, as my sons always tell me, you like me over the other one. Well, today, Chad's my favorite. Scott's not here. Scott.
Sorry, Scott. I'm getting a court.
Scott is an assistant district attorney, and he lives in Savannah, so he could not make it in today. Hopefully, if you come to some other events, you'll meet him. But his twin brother, Chad, works at Emory, does medical research down at Emory. But Chad was actually born with a heart disease, a defect when he was a baby. He had open heart surgery as a two-year-old. So from my perspective, when you think about it, we were 27-year-old parents of twins. That was enough. And we had a child who had to have open heart surgery. We had great health insurance. So his approximately 1984 surgery cost about $80,000. That's just the surgery. That's not all care. It was covered for us, which was great. All of his, you know, physician visits were covered. We were lucky. Because 27-year-olds, how do you decide, you know, you've got another child, how do you decide if you can't, if you don't have health insurance, if you can't afford that, how do you decide not to save one child's life because or lose your home or not be able to afford to pay or feed your family? How do you decide that? Chad actually had his last surgery just last year as a 35-year-old. Now again, he's lucky. He has great health insurance. He works for Emory Healthcare, or Emory University. Which one? Emory University, sorry. So, and they don't have a lifetime max on health insurance, because Chad's probably already reached that. So, you know, his last surgery, he won't tell me the amount because it's his bills, not mine, luckily. But about, you know, $150,000, $200,000 just for the surgery this time. Again, healthcare covered it. But as a 35-year-old, if you don't have that insurance, if you don't have the way to pay it, how do you do that? So part of my obvious position is that everyone needs to be able to afford the health care that they need, period, for the entire lifetime. We should do that. That we can't do that, or we're not willing to do that, to me is just unacceptable. So I'm done with that. I've done my entire career focused on getting everyone fair, quality health care. And that's what I'm going to focus on, one of the issues. So obviously I would be for an expansion of Medicaid. I want to